Dear students, I am Akhtarul Jaman. I am the English teacher of Satyatala High School, Churamankati High School. At this moment, I want to conduct my English class for the students of class 9 and 10. So, my dear students, first I am to give my identity and place dear students notice on the slide. Teacher Akhtarul Jaman, assistant teacher English, Satyendra Churamankati High School, Sadur Joshur. And this class would be conducted for the students of class 9, subject English first part, topic Jainul Abidin, unit 7, lesson 1. So my dear students, you must have to notice something on the board, on the topics or on the board. Dear students, what can you see in the screen? Do you know what is he? My dear students, you must have to notice, or you certainly notice two pictures or two images on the screen. Dear students, you must have to imagine who are the real authority of these pictures, of this image. Dear student, you must have to imagine or guess and try to recognize, try to understand actually what are these two personalities are in the skin. Dear students, do you know who he is? Dear students, what can you see in the skin? Dear students, you certainly know that answers of the questions. I can see in the skin a man or a person. Number two question answer, yes, he is Jainul Abidin, the great artist of Bangladesh. Not only Bangladesh, all over the world. So today's lesson would be lesson declaration. So today's lesson is Jainul Abidin, the great artist of Bangladesh. Dear students, you must have to be attentive to my lecture because it is important for the students of class 9 and 10 for the first paper. Dear students, I want to inspire the students to see or to look at the skin, on the skin having some vocabularies. Dear students, please go through the topics. After going through the topics, students would face some vocabularies as such. I have written down some vocabularies on the skin and you must have to read or go through the vocabulary. Number one vocabulary, pioneers, acclaim, skeptics, document, famine, sinister, skeletal, destined, starvation, flight, defect, compassion, charcoal, iconic, knack, consider, visionary, exhibition, scroll, proper, scroll, poverty, portray, face, abundance, intensify, heighten, non-cooperation, movement, regime, manpura, commemorate, predominant, scenic. These are the vocabularies have been written down by me on the screen. Next, you must have to notice base words and meaning or vocabularies of the vocabulary, meaning or synonym of the vocabularies I have written down on the previous page. Dear students, you must have to be attentive. What is the actual meaning or synonym of the vocabulary spawner? It is a noun. When we will consider it its prepositional form, when we will consider it its parts of its form. Pioneer, the first man in a specific work. Acclaim, this is verb to congratulate anyone. Skepticism, verb, design. Meaning of the skeptics is design. Document, this is noun, its parts of its form. Its meaning is to write down something or to write down anything, or its meaning is proof. Famine, its parts of its speech is noun, wants of food. The famines means is wants of food. Sinister, this is adjective. And its a synonym or meaning is not welcoming, or its another meaning would be spotted. Skeletal, its a parts of a species, adjective, its meaning or synonym is very thin. Distant, it is adjective, its meaning or synonym is besettled of fate, besettled of fate. Next comes starvation. Its parts of species noun. The meaning of starvation or the synonym of starvation is living without food. Next word comes, that is plight. Its a parts of species is noun, and its a synonym or meaning is suffering. Next word comes, it is depict. It is verb, and its a synonym is draw. Next comes compassion. It's a parts of species noun, and its meaning is mercy or favor. Dear students, you must have to notice. So, meaning or synonym of the vocabularies I have uttered sometimes ago. Next, you must have to rest part of the previous slides. Charcoal, it is a noun, has its parts of species form, and its meaning is wood coil. And next comes iconic. It is adjective, and its meaning or synonym is symbolic. Next comes knack. Its meaning is a noun, and it's a parts of species noun, and its meaning or synonym is skill or expertness. Next comes consider. It is a verb, and its meaning or synonym is think or seem. Next comes visionary. It is adjective, and its meaning is imaginative. And finally comes exhibition. It is a noun, and its a meaning or synonym is fair. Dear students, I have written down a lot of vocabularies, and dear students, you must have to understand or realize the topics properly, and exactly you must have to give importance on knowing or understanding these vocabularies. So dear students, let us go to the next topics or next slide, what has been written down there. Dear students, please notice the next slide. In the next slide has been written down rest part of the previous slide. Heighten, it is verb, and its meaning is to make high or develop. Non-cooperation movement, its meaning is not an imperative gathering, and it is noun. Regime, it is eight parts of a species noun, and its meaning is a rule. Next comes a manpura, it is noun, its meaning is a painting by Zainul Abidin to commemorate hundreds and thousands of people who died in 1970 by cyclone. Manpura, it is a great art of Zainul Abidin, and it was drawn by him, and it was a great iconic image, it was a great symbolic image. and which was collected a lot of attraction of the people or personalities of the world, and it was drawn in 1917 when a lot of people were died by cyclone. Next comes commemorate. This is verb and its meaning is to remember with respect. Next comes predominant. Its meaning is adjective. Its meaning is dominant, and its part of speech is adjective. Next comes scenic. It is adjective and its meaning are synonymous natural. Next comes spotlight. It is noun. Meaning is center point. So dear students, you must have to learn or know these sorts of vocabularies of meaning of these topics. Dear students, you must have to notice some important thing, that is the short questions from para first single word. So dear students, I have written down when did Zainul Abidin develop his skills of drawing and painting? Number one question. When did Zainul Abidin develop his skills of drawing and painting? Number two question. What position did Zainul accept in his graduation? What position did Zainul accept in his graduation? Number three. What did he gain while he was still a student of Government Art School of Kolkata? What did he gain when he was still a student of Government Art School of Kolkata? There are three questions I have written down from first para. Dear students, you must have to give its answers, and you must have to try to give its answers. Dear students, you must have to follow the next topic, next slide, and in this slide has been written down the answers of the first para. Dear students, first question's answer would be Zainul Abidin developed his skill of drawing and painting when he was a student. Next question's answer, that is number two question's answer, would be Zainul accepted the first position in the first class in his graduation. Number three question's answer would be while he was still a student of Government Art School of Kolkata, he was appointed a teacher there. So dear students, you will notice the next slide certainly. Next slide certainly. Dear students, as single word, short questions from second para. Short question from second para. It is for the single word. What is number one question? Number one question. What is Zainul Abidin considered? Number one question. I am to repeat. What is Zainul Abidin considered? Number two question. Why does he refer to as Shilpa Sarjo, and what is its meaning? Number two questions. Why does he refer to as Shilpa Sarjo, and what is its meaning? Number three, what is Navanna? Number three, what is Navanna? Number four, what is Manpura? I am to repeat number four question, what is Manpura? I am to give its exact solution. Dear students, answer of the second para. Answer of the second para. Yes. Number one question's answer would be Zainul Abidin is considered the founding father of Bangladesh art. Zainul Abidin is considered the founding father of Bangladesh art. Number two question's answer from second para. For his artistic and visionary qualities, he is referred to as Shilpa Sarjo. Its meaning is the great teacher of art in Bangladesh. Number three question's answer. Navanna is a harvest exhibition in 1969. Navanna is a harvest exhibition in 1979. In the exhibition, he portrayed a 65-foot long scroll highlighting the abundance of poverty in the rural East Pakistan. It also symbolizes the protest of cultural and political freedom against West Pakistan. Number three question's answer I have uttered, I have said sometimes ago. Number four questions answers. Manpura is a painting of 30 foot long scroll which commemorates the death of hundreds of thousands of people in cyclone in 1970. Number four questions answer. I want to repeat that Manpura is a painting of 30 foot long scroll which commemorates the death of hundreds and thousands of people in cyclone in 1971. Dear students, I have given its exact answers of this question. Dear students, you must have to notice an important thing, that is what can you see in the topic? Short question, third para. Short questions from third para. Dear students, you must have to notice one important thing. Number one, short question from third para. What is Sangrahashala? Dear students, you certainly notice a picture, a building on the slide, and in the slide, this picture is considered the great house constructed by Jainul Abidin. Its name is Sangrahashala. And what is its meaning? Sangrahashala is a house where Jainul Abidin, all of its activities, all of its artistic activities were kept in the house. So I have written down its answer. It is an own art gallery of Jainul Abidin. It is an old own art gallery of Jainul Abidin. Dear students, you must have to notice some scene in the screen. Short question from third para. What does the river Brahmaputra play in his life? Dear students, you are observing some pictures on the screen. There are two pictures on the screen. Number one picture, you are observing a river. You are observing a river, and this river has been flowing in the mountain or hill. And another picture is also a river, and it is river Brahmaputra. The two pictures name is Brahmaputra, and these rivers are so much important, are so much beautiful in the eye of Jainul Abidin. So, dear students, what does the river Brahmaputra play in his life? Dear students, Brahmaputra river is such type of river which river played a great or vital role in the life of Jainul Abidin, because all of his activities are drawn or painted by the inspiration from the rivers of Brahmaputra. So, dear students, you can also notice another slide, and on the slide having two scene or two river, and these two rivers are the name of river Brahmaputra, and it is a really exciting river. It is really exciting picture, scenic picture. And in the first picture, the river has been flown between two mountains. And in the second picture, in the river having a great shape, and before the and side of the river having a lot of mountain. So dear students, it is an extraordinary picture. And which pictures or which scene or which thing played a very great role in the life of Jainul Abidin? The river Brahmaputra, dear student, the river Brahmaputra. What I have written, what I have shown, the river Brahmaputra, I have shown at this moment. Dear students, you surely noticed the river Brahmaputra plays a very vital role in his painting, and it's the great source of inspiration, source of source of artistic inspiration. Dear students, if the two rivers, the rivers Brahmaputra is a great thing for the life of Jainal Abhin, and the river Brahmaputra plays a very vital role in his painting, and it is a great source of his artistic inspiration. Dear students, he also observing a picture, and this picture Brahmaputra, river Brahmaputra, and in the picture you are also observing a lot of sailboat, and these boats are moving forward or backward, and over the river having a sky, having a blue sky, and great natural scenic beauties have been depicted by the nature, and these natural beauties charmed Jainul Abidin surely, and we can observe these natural scenic beauties in his artistic activities. So the river Brahmaputra plays a vital role and great source of inspiration, artistic inspiration. So dear students, you are observing some lines on the screen, and number one, combined word, write short notes on the following topics: a series of watercolor, number one, number two, 1938, number three, 1914, and 1976. Dear students, you must have to think, you must have to guess about this marking point. Number one, a series of watercolor. A series of watercolor means Jainul Abidin in his total life, or in his life of painting and drawing, he depicted a lot of pictures, a lot of scene, drawing or painting these pictures or scene, he commonly generally used watercolor comes from river Brahmaputra. So how much grateful, how much effective river Brahmaputra gave in his life, so it is not possible to consider. So number two, 1938, you must have to consider. And 1914 and 1976 is his birth date, and 1976 is his death rate. Dear students, you must have to notice another scene on the screen, number two scene, and I have written down, I have given to you some task: write some sentence about the pages of Constitution of Bangladesh. It is, dear students, you must have know that, I don't know you have not understand about this topic. This is first picture is Constitution of Bangladesh, and this Constitution designer is Jainul Abidin, and our great constitutions of Bangladesh designer Jainul Abidin, and Jainul Abidin and Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman was the personalities who gave order, who gave a request to draw or to paint or to write down the design of the Constitution of Bangladesh. And by the request or by the order of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, Jainul Abidin designed the Constitution of Bangladesh. So at this moment I am to go back to my lesson, because time is over. And dear students, how much you have benefited by my lesson, I don't know, but thank you for all for giving participation in my lectures, and in my next class I will conduct another topics to you, and be stay at your home, and you must have to follow the health hygienic rules, and you must have to be attentive that although your exam is not holding, but you must, your exam is not holding, it means it is not that you are also stopping your studies at home. You must have to remember that studying at home is so much important, and you must have to be attentive to your studies. Thank you very much.